I'm Satyageet.
And we're going to tell you about working on microwave ovens. So, we're going to basically study the three major components of a microwave oven, which are the transformer, the voltage doubler circuit, and the magnetron. So, first we study the transformer. The transformer contains a large number of coils in the secondary winding. So, it magnifies the voltage to a huge level, which is then supplied to the magnetron. Then we study about the voltage doubler circuit. The voltage doubler circuit is a combination of a capacitor and a rectifier used to further boost up the sector voltage to the transformer. So here the diode is forward biased. So the diode acts as a connecting wire, so the capacitor gets fully charged. And no current goes up to the magnetron because it follows the path of the least resistance. And then when the voltage is alternated, we get the diode in a reverse bias. And hence this acts as an open circuit. So now the benefit of this is that we have a double voltage source. Now we have the secondary coil as a voltage source and we have the capacitor acting as a voltage source. And these two voltage sources act together and close the circuit to the magnetron, and then microwaves are produced inside the magnetron. So the third component, which is the most important component, is the magnetron, which produces the microwaves. And it's pretty complicated, so we're just going to basically run through the work. So first of all, we have electrons boiling out of the transformer, as you can see here. Then we have electrons revolving in circular paths due to ring magnets present. And then finally, we have microwaves which are finally produced due to the electron which whip past the cavities inside the magnet. So here are a few pictures of the magnetron from inside. And here are the electrons coming in, the antenna, the microwaves produced. And this is the power source from which we provide voltage. So then we come to the question, what are microwaves? Microwaves are a form of electromagnetic radiation with wavelengths ranging from 1 meter to 1 millimeter with frequencies between 300 megahertz and 300 gigahertz. So here's the electromagnetic spectrum and the microwaves. Right now it's the leftmost half with a really high frequency, and we have the rightmost half. Now this is a little more information about microwaves. Microwaves is the shortest wavelength region of the radio spectrum and a part of the electromagnetic spectrum. We have the frequency range, we have the wavelength range, and we have a diagram showing the microwaves. So finally, we're going to discuss how microwaves actually heat. So molecules inside the food, water molecules, are polar. So we have an electric field rotating at almost 2.5 billion times per second. And the water molecules rotate in order to align themselves along the electric field. So then we have a tremendous amount of molecules rotating inside the food, which provides a huge molecule. Here we have a dipole moment, the alternating electric field, and hence the food gets cooked to a really high temperature. Thanks for watching.